From a numbers game, we've done very well. From a value again, from a value point of view, I mean, I'm talking of value to local Nigerian citizens, probably not as well as we should do. And that is basically been infrastructure driven. Although some of that is gone into, we've increased by 16% the supply from gas to power over the last 2-3 years. Electricity improved. We could do more if there was infrastructure. If the AKK pipeline gets finished, we're looking at about 3,500 megawatts added to the 7,000 that we've been able to find. A lot of stranded power, stranded gas is all infrastructure. So they have to be worked out, you know. So the reality is infrastructure is so key. And if you look at nations of the world that have done well, it is infrastructure. And we have to find that infrastructure investment however we do. But that's what sets us apart from Saudi Arabia, UAE, Qatar, all of them, is infrastructure. And they don't, it's not their money that brings infrastructure, it's investments that bring infrastructure. So this is serious enough, really, to occupy a minister's full time, just dealing with those issues, get the policy in place, get the approvals in place, get the assembly in place, just drive around the whole world finding that money. You know, if you look at the sort of investments that have come in since we, from almost zero investment portfolio, if you, by the time you look at Zaba Zaba and look at Bonga, you look at this, it's over 45 billion potential FIDs. You've not even touched infrastructure, like I said, close to about 30 billion is needed. So those are huge transformative investments for the country. And until we address those, the benefits of gas may be apparent in terms of flare down, but it might not be apparent in terms of value of gas to the citizenry. Now, what have we tried to do? We've tried to pigeon inject in those areas. So we're coming with you know, the concept of LPG penetration. And we've been able to grab penetration by over 600%. We need to do more. We need to get to a point where it's so easy to find cylinders, so easy for virtual gas supplies and filling stations that everybody forms a habit, so that the market woman has no zeal to touch firewood. Because just down his road is a filling plant and he can fill with ease. And with some enhancement, it can even be delivered to his house. And in some areas where you have development of estates, you know, town planning policies may compel people to say pipe gas to the houses, like it's done abroad.
Yes.
So you can see that for each of these, you look at all the components that need to come in for it to work. I can bring the gas into the Lagos doorstep, but how does it get to the average Lagos citizenry? It's going to depend on the investors. The investors who are ready to invest in the gas filling plant, who are ready to put it in their filling stations, who are ready to do the pipelining to the estates that they build. This is not going to do that. You know, but what is important is the consciousness. We produce 2 million barrels of oil. Out of those 2 million barrels, I can tell you today that about 1.1, maybe 1.2 belong to the oil companies. What I mean belong to the oil companies, virtually their own share of JV, PSC, entitlements, because you take your oil in kind, it's not like they pay you money. So they take 1.2 out of the 1.2, out of the 2 million. That's just plus and minus, you know. The federal government has 800,000 barrels, okay? First of all, the person who determines who ships their own 1.2 is the oil company. And I can almost tell you, having worked in the oil company for 30 years, that there's a central marine system in all the oil major companies that goes all over the world to pick up their oil. So if it's oil in here and in Angola, the same vessel will come here, pick it up, pick up one Angola and head to wherever they've sold it to. Most likely it's going to a refinery. So if I then say to the oil companies, no, you cannot pick your oil. I need to suggest to you, the shipper, you're taking a risk, because if there's anything that happens to that oil, you pay them for the full value of the oil. Is that a risk Nigeria wants to take exposure to? So let's pack the oil companies. The best you can do is encourage them as time goes on, where they find opportunity for short-term deliveries. Can they try and use an established Nigerian? Will the established Nigerian shipper be ready to put in 100% guarantee on the product on board the vessel?